All the armies of the world will someday gather, and they'll pass before the great reviewing stand, and they'll beat their swords and their weapons into plowshares, and the Prince of Peace shall give the last command. When King Jesus comes to live with us again, he will show his righteous love to every man. Wars and strife will all be past. There'll be peace on earth at last. When King Jesus comes to live with us again. Yes, at the end of the Great Tribulation, King Jesus will come back with his armies. Those of us who have been raptured will be in our glorified bodies. And we will fight in the Battle of Armageddon. We will be victorious. It will take them a long time to clean up after that battle. And King Jesus will establish his rule and reign upon the earth for 1,000 years. In Matthew's gospel, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ speaks of that ominous moment. Matthew 25, 32 says, "And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats." There are those who've tried to make a great final goat and sheep judgment out of this. But it's not a judgment of individuals, but rather of nations. Nations who have treated God's people, his covenant people Israel, the right way, will go into the millennial reign. Other nations will cease to exist based upon their mistreatment of God's people. I want you to know right now that I believe the Bible literally. Every single word of it is absolutely true. I believe it when it says, "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved." I believe it when it says King Jesus is coming back to rule and to reign. Now, before that ever happens, he is going to rapture us out of this world. There's going to be a terrible time of tribulation down below. But then we're going to rule and reign with him 1,000 years in glorified bodies. What a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful opportunity for us to live now in light of that. We need to be living because our position in the millennial reign of Jesus Christ is being determined even as we speak. How are you serving him? Are you serving him under persecution and affliction and difficulty? Are you doing it faithfully by the grace of God and for his glory? Let's pray. Father, we thank you that King Jesus is coming back. Now we love you, Lord Jesus. We love you and thank you for dying for us, but we serve you now and we want to be faithful and occupy till you come. Help us, bless us, with our head bowed and our eyes closed. If you've never received the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior right now, would you receive him? Just pray something like this. Dear God, I admit that I need a Savior right now. I receive Jesus Christ into my heart. Save me and take me to heaven when I die. If you prayed that prayer, please let us know. And if you're leading others to Christ, please let us know that as well. Right now, let's pray for others. Lord, there are so many that don't know you, and I pray that you'll help us to win them to you. Lord, there are so many right now that are suffering and that are hurting and that have special needs. Lord, I pray that you'll meet them by your grace. And Lord, that right now, as we call out to you, you'll hear and answer prayers according to your perfect will. And we look forward to that time when King Jesus comes back. In his name we pray. Amen and amen. Unobscured, the sun will drive away the shadow. At the dawning of that great millennial day, and there'll be no sounds of crying in the ghettos. For all grief and pain and death shall pass away. When King Jesus comes to live on earth again, he will show his righteous love to every man. Wars and strife will all be past. There'll be peace on earth at last. when King Jesus comes to live with us again. Wars and strife will all be past. There'll be peace on earth at last when King Jesus comes to live with us again. Have a great day serving the Lord today.